Raging California wildfires turning deadly today. The first reported casualties in Northern California, where five people were found dead in torched vehicles after the fire quadrupled in size overnight to nearly 300 square kilometers.
Across the state, fires forcing more than 150,000 people from their homes. Now, there are three major fires that have been burning out of control, including one charring parts of Thousand Oaks. That's in Ventura County, the very site of this week's mass shooting.
All of this smoke is actually rising up to our altitude here at about 6,800 feet.
You know, this last 48 hours, 72 hours in Ventura County has been a difficult time. I appreciate everybody's efforts and kind prayers for all the people from our victims that lost their lives in a shooting to now what's happening, people losing their homes. It's a difficult time.
So we are still reeling, but we are also very resilient. This is a very stressful time. Many of our first responders haven't slept.
A tragic timing of events. A fire evacuation center in Thousand Oaks has also served as a family reunification site following this week's shooting at a bar and grill where a former U.S. Marine opened fire, killing 12 people before it's believed he turned the gun on himself. Fires forcing the closure of many schools today in Ventura and Los Angeles counties, the city of Malibu under an evacuation order. Wind whip flames charring tens of thousands of acres across the state. Fire officials say the Woolsey Fire, which jumped a freeway today, is their priority, saying it packs an extraordinary threat to life and property.
This thing moves fast and you need to be prepared. So if you're ready to go, go. And if you're being told to go, get out of there.
Extreme fire danger warnings are in effect throughout many areas of California, with the low humidity and strong winds which are fueling the flames expected to continue through this evening.